What kind of breakfast do you do? Sweet or savoury? And what about the dog? Well, it's here, so it's nothing now. Let's sit together and find out what is the best way to have your breakfast. Welcome back on the channel. I am Pasquale and I'm your nutrition and lifestyle coach. After the breakfast video I shot some time ago, I thought I had said it all, but as an Italian, I was wrong. In fact, as I watched a story on Instagram of one of my science gurus here on the internet, Dario Bersanini, I realized that I overlooked something. A user asked Dario if it was better to have a savoury or sweet breakfast. And then I started to cry because I thought, well, I'm an idiot. Dario Bersanini is a university professor and a chemist of a certain importance. Let's say that if you speak Italian and you're not subscribed to his YouTube channel, well, I don't trust you at all. However, Lily, if you want to see all the fake nutritional facts disassembled scientifically in a few seconds, subscribe to the channel of Dario Bersanini. Assuming that breakfast should give you the energy needed to start the day, which way is better? The one with the savoury taste or with the sweet taste? We Italians are accustomed to have it sweet, maybe with croissant, a cappuccino or some biscuits, or with sweet brioche. Here in Ireland you do it with sausages, bacon and eggs. Who's wrong and who's right? Let's see some differences together. Also, at the end of this video, I will give you 5 guidelines to follow to avoid making wrong breakfasts. If you follow me for a while, you know already that I always recommend a good protein intake in the morning, about 19 grams. This need has nothing to do with exceptional beneficial effects, slimming stuff or magician things. Basically, I gave you this advice because proteins have a greater satiating effect. If you eat proteins together with a good supply of fibers, then you will feel full for a longer period of time and you will increase the time within which the feeling of hunger will occur. In general terms, the amount of protein, carbohydrate and fats, as well as the intake of minerals and vitamins, is to be summed at the end of each day. A richer protein breakfast will simply mean that during the rest of the day you will have to lunch and dinner, snacks, a quantity of protein that summed throughout the day should not exceed the day requirements. So if these proteins at breakfast come from a sweet or a savoury meal, it doesn't really matter. The same applies to fats and carbohydrate. What matters is the quality of the macronutrient sources. That makes the difference for sure. Protein's quality in sausage, for example, are totally different from the one in eggs. A slice of wholemeal bread is totally different from a biscuit slice or a white bread slice or processed snacks. Let's see some examples to understand clearer. We take a simple croissant and a small cappuccino and a single teaspoon of sugar. This is the breakfast that an average Italian does in the morning at the bar. A breakfast considered sweet. Let's see it in details. We have about 390 kilocalories, a good calorie intake for breakfast, but the quality is not just made up with calories. If we look in the detail, we have introduced about 13.5 grams of sugar. It is the 25% and so a quarter of the maximum recommended daily intake is high, damn. But it's not only this, the problem here is the glycemic index, which is 96 for a croissant, and it is very high. This means that a breakfast of this kind causes you an aberrant insulin spike. Also, look at details of the macronutrients where you can see that the fats are also a quarter of a maximum of daily amount. Now let's move to another typical sweet breakfast. Bread, butter and jam, of course a cappuccino here with another teaspoon of sugar. In this second example you will be surprised. Let's see it together. Here we have a less caloric breakfast, about 262 kilocalories, but the sugar are rising to the sky. Here we have half of the maximum daily amount. And here too the glycemic peak plays table tennis with your cells. Here, however, macronutrients are a little less dramatic, but still look at the details. Now let's see a sweet breakfast that could be more balanced. Here I have a pot of whole yogurt without any added sugar, 2 dates and 50 grams of nuts and seeds. 2 dates contain about 9 grams of sugar and even if they have a higher glycemic index of jam, due to the fact that the nuts, dates and yogurt contain fats, and I must say excellent fats quality, we have here a very low glycemic load. Also check out the micronutrients report here. Now we see a typical savoury Irish breakfast, a slice of bacon, a sausage, an egg and a piece of bread with a bit of butter on top and a black American coffee. As you can see here, the breakfast is incredibly unbalanced towards the excess of fats, which are abnormal limits. Of these fats, I also show here that over half is more than saturated fats. And also the sodium intake here is frightening, it's half of the daily requirement. An abomination for your health. Now, let's see a better alternative for a savory breakfast. Here I have a scrambled egg, a slice of wholemeal bread with a bit of tomatoes and a little olive oil as a dressing. I also have a black American coffee here without any sugar. Now look at the macronutrients report. It's a more balanced situation here. The fats are only 11 grams, which is about a seventh of the recommended intake, and the cholesterol of the eggs is a good quality one. Moreover, the vitamin C contained in the tomato is with about 10 milligrams, helps to improve the absorption of iron present in this meal, increasing its utilization. So what I wanted to tell you with this example, that it makes no sense to be on one side of the other of the barricade by supporting the savory of a sweet breakfast. We're not in a football game here. Ingredients quality is the key here. You must use good quality ingredients. Avoid food rich in industrial fats or added sugar or added salts, and give space to foods that are rich in fiber and are more natural. Before to end this video, as I promised, I want to give you 5 usual guidelines or tips to pay attention to, so that you can have a better breakfast, sweet or savory, whatever you want to. Number one is to avoid food rich in salt or sugar, and in any case, avoid adding them. The sugar will raise you the insulin peak in your calories intake. Excess of sodium will disrupt the pump sodium potassium in your cell and can cause cardiovascular diseases. Number two is to prefer fresh food and not processed food. If I have not convinced you to avoid any sugar-rich food, and you want to eat a cake, at least make it to yourself at home. There will be less junk ingredients and less sugar for sure. Number three, try to have at least 3 different kind of breakfast per week. Whether they are sweet or savory, it doesn't matter. But if you stick always to the same one, if you get annoyed at some point, it's easier for you to be developing bad food habits. Number four, try to have your breakfast calmly. I can assure you that it creates more stress eating your pancake while you're in the loo because you're in a rush, rather than waking up half an hour earlier and taking up your time to have your breakfast. Then you can have number one and number two later. Think about it, if you eat while pooing, you have a serious issue here. Finally, number five, make sure that all your breakfasts have all the macronutrients, carbohydrate, fat and protein. A nutritional intake with all macronutrients together with fibers, minerals and vitamins will make you more active and ready for the day that is about to begin. Before to leave, I just want to apologize for the quality of the video and because I am 2 weeks late on the video, and this happened because my camera broke down and I still have a cold, so I just shot in this video with this kind of hair style like John Lennon in the 60s with the Beatles. Before to go, I want to remind you to subscribe the channel and click the bell to get new update. If you like the video, please thumbs up. If you didn't like the video, thumbs up too, because otherwise you make the dog sad. I also have a Facebook and an Instagram page. Please follow me also on those social. And my website, www.healthmefood.com. Please share this video on the social networks and help me grow this channel so I can spread my message to more people. What I'm left to say, eat well, live well, and smile, and see you next time. Ciao.